So welcome back to my channel. So we'll be discussing cranial nerves part 2, where I'll be discussing the 4th, 5th and 6th cranial nerves. So the 4th cranial nerve is the trochlear nerve, which is general somatic efferent and has its motor nucleus in the midbrain at the level of the inferior colliculus. It has the longest intracranial course and it's the smallest nerve. That means it's the smallest of the cranial nerves. It's dorsally located and decussates. That means that the left trochlear nucleus will innervate the right superior oblique muscle. So it passes between the posterior cerebral and superior cerebellar arteries, and then it's found in the lateral wall of the cavernous sinus, passes via the superior orbital fissure to go to the orbit, and it will innervate the superior oblique muscle. The trigeminal nerve has multiple nuclei. At the level of the pons, you have the motor nucleus and the chief sensory nucleus. So the motor nucleus is general somatic efferent, and the chief sensory nucleus is general somatic afferent. The motor nucleus innervates the muscles of mastication. The chief sensory nucleus is responsible for touch sensation. The mesencephalic nucleus is at the level of the midbrain and is responsible for proprioception. The spinal nucleus of the trigeminal runs through all the major parts of the brainstem, and it's for pain and temperature sensation from the head region. And so the sensory nuclei of the trigeminal are general somatic afferent. That is their functional classification. The trigeminal nerve is found at the midpoint of the middle cerebellar peduncle, with two major nervelets, what we call the posterior major and the posterior minor. So the posterior major is sensory, or the posterior minor is motor. The sensory branches will be majorly running through the ophthalmic and maxillary, with the mandibular also providing a bit of sensory. Now the trigeminal ganglion, where this sensory relay occurs, is also known as the Cassarian ganglion, and is found in a dural reflection known as Merkel's cave. The mandibular nerve runs through the foramen ovale to innervate the muscles of mastication, and the buccal sensory branch also comes from the mandibular. Now the ophthalmic and maxillary are purely sensory, and they run through the lateral of the cavernous sinus. The maxillary, however, will exit via the foramen rotundum, go through the inferior orbital fissure to end up in the infraorbital foramen. The ophthalmic nerve will pass the superior orbital fissure, go through the orbit, then end up in the ethmoidal foramina. So this is the distribution of the trigeminal. So you can see from the forehead to the lateral angle of the eye, or what you call the lateral canthus, to the tip of the nose. This is the distribution of the ophthalmic nerve. Then from the lateral aspect of the forehead, through the lateral angle of the eye, to the lateral part of the nose, the lateral aspect of the ala of the nose, up to the level of the angle of the mouth. This distribution is maxillary. And then from the lateral angle of the mouth to the body of the mandible, this distribution is mandibular. Now this preauricular region, there is usually an overlap with other sensory nerves, such as the greater auricular and the auriculotemporal nerves. So there is a bit of overlap in this preauricular region. So mandibular will majorly be from this lateral angle of the mouth to the body of the mandible. The abducens is general somatic efferent. So its nucleus, which is motor, is at the level of the pons. And this is the phenomenon, what you call the facial colliculus, where the facial nerve usually runs over the motor nucleus of the abducens. So it exits via the pontomedullary junction just above the pyramids and will enter the pontine cistern. So remember, a cistern is an enlarged subarachnoid space with CSF. So it runs through that cistern and eventually goes the floor of the cavernous sinus, where it runs with the internal carotid artery. So it passes through the superior fissure, goes to the orbit where it innervates the lateral rectus muscle. And because of the fact that it enters the pontine cistern, it has the longest subarachnoid course. Thank you. If there is any question, you can leave them on the comment section below.